Greetings, everyone, and welcome to part two of Count Dracula from the BBC, starring Louis Jordan. All right, let's get right into it, shall we? Is everybody queued up on part two, ready to rock and roll, ready to go right out of control? I'm assuming you know what to do if you're watching part two that you watched part one, so I'm not going to give you all the instructions again. You know the drill. Look in the description if you don't have the video, or, just quickly run off to Amazon and buy the DVD, and you'll be all set. Okay? Good. Excellent. They have, unless their teleporter isn't working today, in which case you might have to wait till tomorrow, but that's okay. The video's not going anywhere. Alrighty. Here we go. Part two. The epic conclusion. Ready on 3, 2, 1, play! Here we go. Van Helsing. I'm just having some leftover chicken Alfredo. I just like to say, I love this Van Helsing. The actor is Frank Finlay, and it's one of my favorites. I was just like, I'm not having any of that. And your lust for blood. When did that begin? I love that he doesn't betray anything to her. Like, you know that he knows something's up and what to look for. But he just keeps it very casual. Everything he looks at, he reacts the same way so as not to alarm her. Thank you. Good. Well, I'm getting the fuck out of here. Bye. And that's the last we see of Van Helsing. And the horror can continue unfettered. Let's all laugh at her. Her misfortune is amusing. I've been asleep for hours. Oh, damn. Thank you. No, Krillatin, it did not. No, Krillatin, he wasn't. He's like, really? That's what it's called? Okay. The jam of the door. No, Krillatin. It was not. It was horrifying. We must trust. Yeah, that's right. Silly girl, don't wear this stinky stuff. What are you doing? Don't take the garlic off! I think she died. She literally died of fright. Formed into a face. dear. Dear. No reflection. I love how Van Helsing is just like, not on your life. Yeah, that was the thing. She healed overnight because she's almost completely turned. So now she's got, like, the accelerated healing. They eloped. But the monster said he'd be there on his wedding night. Oh, wait a minute. Wrong one. Sorry. Paprika chicken. Is that what Dracula was making for him? Did he make him eat paprika chicken every night? I wonder if that's the only thing Dracula knew how to cook. That's one of the things about him having no servants. They brought this up in Shadow of the Vampire. Whoa. But yeah, they brought that fact up in Shadow of the Vampire, the fact that Dracula had no servants, so. So he was cooking the meals and making the beds and doing the dishes, and how long has it been since he's tasted food? Would he even know how to cook? From joy to despair in a matter of minutes. He's so matter of fact about it. And then what? Cut off her head. His way of saying no guff. Or no shit, Sherlock. Yeah, right, Stout. Dear. Hi, Quincy, want to make out? Okay. Nope. That's cool. That's a cool effect. Oh, Stoud. Me too. Damn, there's a Ha ha ha. It's pretty gruesome for 1977 TV. Wow. Fifty, yeah. Let's all hold hands and sing Ring Around the Rosie. Well, it's a no longer. the blandest crackers in the world. Taste of my incredibly bland flesh. And get drunk off my blood. I missed one single hair when I shaved earlier. How does that even happen? Disgusting! Okay, yeah, they're in Carfax. Rats, 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 thousands of them, millions of them. Where, what, where, who, what, eh, ah, oh, a painting. Oh, I don't think that's what they're looking at. Ah, it's a nice little fake out. We thought that's what they're looking at. Like, what? It's a painting and some knickknacks? What's the big deal? Oh, that's nice. Look at that. Framed by the frame of the bed. And that, by the windows. And the mist, and the da da ba da ba da ba. I love the BBC. Yes, Jonathan frequently enters the room in the form of a dense mist. That's pretty rad. I love dry ice. Coolest misty mist. Should have covered yourself in garlic. Of course, at this point, they had no idea he was going to come after Mina. Hello. I love this. Ah. Other than he's just making cocoa for everybody. Two parts chocolate, one part milk. There you go. Oh yeah, I guess he is making it with actual proper milk. Hey, welcome back, Stoud. And anyone else who was having issues? Does he get some? What a nice guy. Makes cocoa for everyone except himself. Oh. Well, that's annoying, Stout. I'm sorry that that's happening. That's why he didn't recognize her. He can sense that Dracula's done something to her. Old David Tennant. That is something I wouldn't mind seeing, actually. David Tennant as Renfield in a Dracula adaptation. I think he could really do something interesting with that. Or at the very least be incredibly entertaining. Thanks, Stoud. It's the redemption of Renfield. Damn. That is a good death gurgle. He won't wait. Oh. Again, there I go. Being the characters in the movie. Another one I missed.
Oh.
Yes, I want to suck your blood. line. That sums up what Dracula is right there. And what so many of the movies get wrong. Do you know the significance of the kiss? You are nourishment to me, my beautiful wine press. He literally just told her to her face, you are nothing more than food. Yes, it just came in twice. I don't know why. Some kind of dramatic effect that I don't understand. Oh, God. She's like covered in blood. Unclean. Out, damn spot! I love the pure, raw emotion that she imbues her performance with. Really, really well done. Dude, there's like literally 26 minutes left. You can't... Oh, well. Oh, well. Thanks for joining us for most of it. No worries. I know what over-retired feels like, believe me. Have a good one, Kershak. Thanks for coming out. We'll be doing lots more of these over the next couple months, so drop in anytime. Is my domain. a lot of cheese and garlic in all the food I had tonight. So, yeah. Oh, look at that reflection. It's beautiful. Come on. On 49 of the 50. This is something that's not in all the versions either, but it's straight from the book. It's basically with Mina now having a connection. I was gonna say, like, the fact that she's now connected to Dracula and can help them find him. That's something that you don't see in all the different versions. Me if I stuff my face in front of you. Uh-oh. It sounds like a party. Such fun. Like to share in some roast rabbit. Sorry. I mean to be farting my way through this superb adaptation of Dracula. It is what it is. Ah, sort of the equivalent of sprinkling salt. Nope. That was a test. Now he knows. She's too far along. Double protection. They can't get past the circle. They cannot. Cannot stand against the power of the wafer. Man, I I love that scene. It was so well done. I love just how subtle, like, it wasn't over, like, if that was, say, an American production, I think the temptation would be to over-dramatize it with music and sound effects and stuff. But there really wasn't, other than the thunder at the tail end of it, there was no sound except for the crackling fire and the whispering voices of the brides, which I think is just wonderful. And it was so tense. You know, it was great. Chat is so quiet. Anybody still alive out there? Or did all the vampire brides get you? I don't know, my VLC player has been acting wonky tonight for some reason. I'm playing just a rip of the DVD. Which should perform better than the disc, but for some reason the audio sync keeps drifting. So if I quickly tap the pause on and off, it resyncs it. But it's weird. It's been doing that all through the movie. You sleep. I'm gonna go kill your sisters. Okay. Down. Let's do this one over here, right there. Okay. Damn. No prayer for the dead this time? I guess it doesn't matter. They're too far gone. And done. The last box. There it is. Okay, hold on a second. I'm a little confused with the geography here. So, the vampire brides presumably live at Castle Dracula, so they're going to Castle Dracula. They gotta beat Dracula to Castle Dracula. So he went to Castle Dracula presumably to kill the brides. Then he has to go back and get Mina, and then they gotta race him back to Castle Dracula? Why doesn't he just wait at Castle Dracula? He's already there. Three-dimensional chess, clearly. Hmm. Good shot. It's a good old-fashioned shootout. Oh, no. Oh, no. Damn it. Get your gun out. No, Quincy. In the face. Yeah, there you go. Don't mess with Texas. Oh, shit. Damn, Mina. Oh, one of them's getting away. I think you're better with a steak, Van Helsing. Yep, definitely better with a steak. A sniper you are not. Should have let Mina take the shot. Oh, no, you don't. Is that Quincy? Stack, yep. Yeah, because in the book, they're racing Dracula back to the castle before sundown. They got to get there before the sun goes down. Because, while sunlight is not lethal to Dracula in the book, his power is greatly reduced during the day. He's weaker. At night, he's at full power, full strength. And I think in the book they don't actually get to the castle, or they just get to the castle, but then that's where they have their shootout with the gypsies. Okay, yeah. So I mean, the sequence of events is slightly different in this, but otherwise it's pretty close. Too late. Oh! Nice! I like the dramatic pause there. Oh! He's exploding! He didn't even use the hammer. He just rammed it in there. Oh, did you need to behead him? Is there even anything left? He just completely disintegrated. And thus endeth the chronicle. Why, thank you, Krillatin. Much obliged. Wow, Stoud. Wow. God damn it, Stoud. You've been waiting since we pressed play on part one just to say that at the end, haven't you? This whole time. Oh, God, Krillatin. I just don't know what your standards are. Like, what are you expecting? Jesus fucking Christ. Literally the most faithful adaptation ever done. Ever. It has yet to be beaten. Ugh. Louis Jordan, one of the all-time great performances as the Count. Frank Finlay, one of the all-time great Van Helsings. Oh my God, I'm in a room full of Philistines. Well, I hope you, who was not here when it was live, enjoyed it as much as I did. Apparently, I am with a very tough crowd here that is impossible to please. And if they rate that fucking Francis Ford Coppola movie higher than this one, I would be very cross indeed. Anyway, thank you for joining us. Hope you all enjoyed. Those of you on Twitch, I'm not coming back online today because you pissed me off. No, just kidding. I'm going to head to bed. I have a lot of issues with the Francis Ford Coppola one. So many issues. But we'll get into that another time. That one's like a 5-point. Thank you, Stoud. Finally. There's a little sliver of redemption there. Ah, okay. Well, have yourselves a wonderful day or night. Thanks for joining us. Hope you enjoyed the film. It is absolutely one of my favorite versions of Dracula. Like I said, after being having this recommended to me, not like I need to show you the cover, it's literally on the screen three times. But anyway, after having it recommended by some of you last year, it instantly became a favorite of mine. And this is the third or fourth time actually that I've watched it, and I just love it. It's great stuff. Love The Rent, especially for me. The standout performances were Louis Jordan as Dracula, Frank Finlay as Van Helsing, and the guy who played Renfield. Old David Tennant, as was it Kershak said earlier. But Jack Shepard. Jack Shepard, that's who it was. So it said cast list on the back. Thank you very much, BBC Video. Alrighty. Well, that is it for us. Oh, God. I don't know how anyone can rate the Coppola one that highly, seriously. Visually, it's very pretty. But beyond that, there are so many issues with it. Like, so many freaking issues. Anyway, we'll get into that another time. I don't hate it. Don't get me wrong. I don't hate it. I just have some issues with it. I would not rate it higher than this one. This one, for all its lack of budget and production value in contrast, I think is the superior adaptation. There you go. That's as much of a hint as you get for when we do the Coppola one. Alrighty. Have yourselves a great day or night. And as someone who's actually read the book, fuck you, Krolatin. I mean, thanks for watching, and sayonara.